Thank you, Frank. So that's Saturday evening, 8:30 to 9:30. Meeting 8:30 at the canal, where we have a special time when we mark Earth Hour and we come up here to the church bank for a short service. So we look forward to that. If you're able to come, it will be a quiet, thought-provoking and atmospheric experience. Saturday evening, put it in your diaries and come to the church. Thanks, Frank, for that. That's Caring for Creation team. Thank you. It is with regret that I intimate Bette Smith's passing, and Bette's funeral service is here in the church on Tuesday at 12 noon, and then at Dalgowie Crematorium at 1:30 p.m. And I commend our family to your prayers. Men's Club meet on Tuesday, it's their AGM down at the South Hall, 1 o'clock if you're coming for lunch, and 2 o'clock for the meeting. So that's on Tuesday. The Guinness Brigade want to thank you all for the support that you gave them last week at their coffee, at their soup and sweet bite lunch. And they raised £375. Isn't that wonderful? And this gives them a great boost to the company funds. They're delighted with this. Intimation from the Guild, the visit to Fairley Guild this Tuesday will leave from the church at Canal Bank at approximately 12:45 p.m. And we'll also pick up members of Eagle Lodge at approximately 1. They've asked me to intimate that their Taylor fashion event raised the magnificent sum of £830 during the week. And a very big thanks to all who supported the Guild by contributing to the raffle or coming along in the evening. And the Guild's final meeting of this session is the Daffodil Tea on Thursday, 30th of March, in the South Halls at 7:30 p.m. and the entertainment is by Harmony. So well done to the Guild. The Lodging House Mission, which is a vital part of the Church of Scotland here in Glasgow, their initiative this year is to share the message of life, hope, and meaning by donating an Easter egg with a label, A Gift of Hope. And you can bring them to the church next Sunday's the last Sunday to be able to do this. So if you want to support Lodging House Mission by bringing an Easter egg, please do by next week. And the Cadder Singers, just for noting, Easter gathering is Wednesday, 29th of March, 7 p.m. in the South Hall. Popular songs and well-known hymns, which will begin to focus us for Easter. So these are the intimations, Matthew. You give me a wee clap for them now, just because I'm stopping. Anyway, this morning, Rona is going to lead us in the service. Rona has 3 full services to take before she finishes at the end of May with us. And this is one of the 3. So, Rona, we're going to hand over to you to take the service just in a few moments. But please take this time before we start just to turn and say hello to each other this morning.
Thank you. August 21.
Thank you.
know that it's in here. I can put my hand on it. And if I put my hand on it, what happens? How will I know? I can feel it pumping blood through my body. That's our hearts, isn't it? They keep us going. They keep us warm. They keep us powered up. I've got something else that keeps things powered up. I'm just going to come round here and pick it up. Don't worry, it's not a trick. I think you'll know what this is too. It's what's on. You know what these are? Batteries. These are all set up for the recycling prank. Earth hour. I'm prepared. Lots of different types of batteries, isn't there? What shapes can you see? You see that big square one? That's huge. What do you think that's from? A camera? I think it might be. I think it might actually be from... What's those other things going on? Look at. Oh yeah, mobile phone. What else do you find batteries in? Toys? What else do you find batteries in? Electric cars? Clocks, that's a good one. Clocks, toys, electric cars, phones, anything else? Screwdrivers, if you've got an electric screwdriver, absolutely. What else? Video games, yeah, video controls, drills, loads of things. And what happens when the battery runs out? Can't use it. And you recharge it. There's nothing more annoying there, you get the remote control, it's not working, and the batteries have run out, and you need to recharge them, don't you? And you know what I think about, when I think about God and I think about Jesus, I think about them being like a battery for me. They connect me with God and Jesus, like the thing that powers me in my life. And when I want to recharge, I pray, or come to church, and I spend time with God and Jesus, and it recharges the power in my life. It's funny to think about it, isn't it? Sometimes it's hard to think about God and who is God and what's happening. And sometimes we can think about God and Jesus like a battery. And it's our job as Christians to make sure that the power doesn't run out, but we keep ourselves recharged and we keep connecting with God and Jesus. And I know that you do that in Cadder Kids up in the hall. Yeah? So you've finished making all the gifts for everyone. So I hope you're doing something fun for yourself this morning. Don't know. Well, I'm sure you're charged up and you're ready to go. So you guys go and have a seat. I think we'll have a wee prayer out of our love for Mother's Day. You're welcome to stand up here with me if you like. We're going to do a prayer. Do you want to stay here while we do the prayer, or would you like to sit down? You just take your time, Charlotte. Let's say a short prayer for Mother's Day. Lord, for all the mothers that are still with us, and for those who have gone to be with Jesus, we give thanks today. Some in addition to our own mothers, some in place of absent mothers. We recognise and give thanks for them. For all women who have been figures of grace and of love in our lives, whose example is meaningful to us, we give thanks. And we pray, Lord, that this day brings gifts of your love and care to all we've prayed for. Amen. Enjoy your morning and your fun together, and thank you so much for your love and kindness for us. Thank you so much. We're going to sing together, before the kid plays up, the hymn number 186, Father God, I Wonder.
Thank you.
a mother's heart fills with joy as she gazes at her child, so your heart bursts with delight as you look on us, your children. Thank you for your forgiving love that covers all our failures and continues to make things new. You promise never to let us go. So then, encouraged, we stand on this promise and meet with you in confidence that we are welcome at each moment of our life's journey. Calm the storms within us, Lord, and around us, that we may know your rest and your refuge, that we may approach our time together with peace in our hearts and joy in our step and love in our words. And we ask this in Jesus' name, as we say together the words he taught us to say. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. Your kingdom and power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And Irene is going to read to us.
An Old Testament reading is the book of Psalms, Psalm 23. And you'll find it on page 549 of the Pew Bible. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. He lets me rest in fields of green grass and leads me to quiet pools of fresh water. He gives me new strength. He guides me in the right paths, as he has promised. Even if I go through the deepest darkness, I will not be afraid, Lord, for you are with me. Your shepherd's rod and staff protect me. You prepare a banquet for me where all my enemies can see me. You welcome me as an honored guest and fill my cup to the brim. I know that your goodness and love will be with me all my life, and your house will be my home as long as I live. And the New Testament reading is from Ephesians chapter 5. You'll find this on page 243 of the New Testament section. We ourselves used to be in darkness, but since we have become the Lord's people, we are in the light. So we must live like people who belong in the light, for it is the light that brings a rich harvest of every kind of goodness, righteousness, and truth. Try to learn what pleases the Lord. Have nothing to do with the worthless things that people do, things that belong to the darkness. Instead, bring them out to the light. It is really too shameful even to talk about things we do in secret. And when all things are brought out into the light, then your true nature is clearly revealed. For anything that is clearly revealed becomes light. That is why it is said, wake up, sleeper, and rise from death, and Christ will shine on you. Amen. Thanks be to God for the children from his holy word.
Amen. Thank you, Irene. We will continue our worship with song, this time hymn number 559. There is a reading.
Thank you.
in January when John was on study leave, I mentioned in a children's talk that I was invited to Rio in Brazil. And if you didn't hear that story, or if you've forgotten, I had met an American girl in the bank while I was on holiday in Ibiza, the Spanish island. She was behind me in the queue and she was alone. It was her last day of her holiday. And I invited her for coffee and a cake with myself and my sister and my friend. And she spent the whole of her last day with us. Months and months later, having never heard from her again, I received an email with the title, "Are you the girl I met in the bank?" I replied, "Yes." And she replied, "Would you like to come to Rio?" I replied, "Yes." Her email explained that she would be there on holiday and that she would be going to the carnival in Rio and that she would be on her own and she would love my company and I didn't need to worry about anything. I just had to get a flight and everything else would be paid for and taken care of. So there I was in Rio the very next week. As part of a wonderful and truly, truly amazing week of experiences every day, on one of the days I was given a ticket to something called the Copacabana Palace Carnival Ball. The Copacabana Palace is a huge, huge building that looks onto Copacabana Beach. It's very grand with huge balconies that you can stand out on and socialise on and take in the view. This was a big night. These tickets were expensive, around about £2,000 I was led to believe, not anything that I had to part with, which in itself was truly amazing. But this was a big night before the start of the carnival in Rio. It was a red carpet affair. It was also a masquerade ball in which an abundance of food and drinks were served all night. I will never forget arriving up to this Copacabana Palace, walking on the red carpet, cameras of paparazzi flashing, not at me, and entering this huge marble hallway. And there in front of me was a massive banquet table that extended the whole way of the hallway. It had exotic foods and all the food you can ever think of spread along this table. And in between it, gold statues of tigers, as I was eating. It was quite a sight. Drinks flowed from silver platters all night and up to about, I think, 6 o'clock in the morning. I remember thinking, someone is going to find me out here. Someone's going to find out that I'm not rich, and I'm not famous, and I can't speak Portuguese. And then I thought, oh well, I'll just tell them a story about buying the cup of tea and the croissant, and I'm sure they'll understand. Isn't this what God prepares us for? At the end of hard times and the ups and downs of life, a place at a table to dine with him, a banquet as his honorary guest. God wants to be in our celebrations and calls us as a guest of honor to a banquet he prepares to come and rejoice with him. In the well-known psalm that we heard I read say today, Psalm 23, God is the great shepherd who keeps us safe and keeps us provided for, ensures we can access water and resting places, and guards us through the darkness. And then right there, at probably the lesser well-known verse 5 at the end, we We find ourselves out of that hard time and into the banquet with him as the guest of honour. And there are other examples in the Bible where God is described as celebrating with us in a really lavish way, like the story of the return of the prodigal son. There was the son away spending his inheritance that he had demanded his dad give him earlier than his dad had planned to. There was the son going through life's ups and downs and having come through the dark place of having nothing left, he comes back to the safety of his home and there he is met with a lavish banquet in which he's the guest of honour in his dad's house. But the psalmist, who is David, he doesn't stop there. He says, "You prepare a banquet for me where all my enemies can see me." As I was thinking about this week, I was thinking, who are those enemies that are seeing these celebrations? And I realised that there are two different perspectives on this, of who the enemies can be. One is that the enemies are actually psychological, that the enemies are our own negative thoughts. They're our own thoughts of unworthiness, of being at the table with God. We know from the reading of the prodigal son that he was ashamed. He was sorry for the path that he'd taken, and he was hoping to be forgiven. As he banquets with his father, he may feel he's doing so in front of and despite of his own feelings of unworthiness about himself. In our New Testament reading, Paul is writing to the Ephesians, the people of a place of Ephesus on the west coast of what is now modern day Turkey. Paul is encouraging them to remember that they are worthy of God's love, that in knowing God, they are children of the light. Paul recognises how hard it is to keep that positive thought process, because later in this letter is a well-known description of putting on the armour of God, an illustration of how they're protected by God. In his encouraging letter, Paul is recognising the psychological worries that can inhibit someone from thinking that they're welcome. The imposter syndrome that they can hold within themselves. Paul wants the Ephesians to know that they are worthy of being God's guest of honour at the banquet. The other and second way of thinking about enemies is that they're actually people. People with all those negative thoughts about you, if you're not thinking them about yourself, then they are thinking them for you. One of the reasons that Paul is so keen to encourage the Ephesians to be confident as children of the light is because they were not always with God. As Gentiles, the Ephesians would have viewed the Jews as enemies and vice versa. In the letter, which is earlier than the reading we heard, so in chapter 2, verse 14, Paul writes this: "For Christ himself has brought us peace by making Jews and Gentiles one people. With his own body he broke down the wall that separated them and kept them enemies." Paul is encouraging them to see themselves as one with other people, and not as the divided communities of faith. Because Jesus opens the door for everyone to come to the table, no matter their background. In the psalm, David is king, so King David, who's writing the psalm, Psalm 23, he no doubt has physical enemies. There's no doubt that there would have been people around him that would have been questioning what he was capable of as a king, questioning his leadership and questioning his decisions that he had made. And the prodigal son, the brother was one of the enemies watching the banquet. Jealous that his brother was receiving attention, critical of the level of forgiveness and generosity that his father was providing throughout the celebration. Despite these enemies, God makes us feel special, regardless of what others think. We see this throughout the Bible. We see it in Jesus' ministry. He's forever calling forward those who are judged and looked down upon by others, and he brings them in front of others. He makes them feel special. He heals them, he cares for them, and treats them as a guest of honour with enemies observing. God loves us, and as a mother's love is unconditional, a parent's love is unconditional, God's love as a parent for us is unconditional. A parent recognises the journey the child is on and is willing to celebrate each milestone along that child's trials of life, its ups and downs. But loving each other is actually much more difficult. It might be easy to be the enemy at someone else's banquet. How often do we judge what others are doing on their life journey? As I considered this week, I asked myself, am I the enemy at someone else's banquet? In 1993, Michael O'Mahony Owu was born to his Ghanaian mother in Croydon, London, 1993, not that long ago. He grew up in London in a childhood with gang culture and knives. Himself being charged for possession of a knife, he has scars on his own head from a violent altercation, and he has witnessed friends die from life on the streets where he grew up. Brought up as a Christian, Michael's mother prayed consistently as she watched her son journey through dark times. Today, Michael is 29 years old and is a music artist known as Stormzy. His debut album in 2017, called Gang Signs and Prayers, reached number one in the charts. Stormzy is a rapper of the grime music scene, and his lyrics are colourful, using language that some may find offensive, or say perhaps is not Christian. Stormzy writes about God, and in his second album, within a song called The Crown, he writes these lyrics, which I'm not going to rap at all. He says this, I have my reasons, and life has its lessons. I tried to be grateful and count all my blessings, but heavy is the head that wears the crown. Amen in Jesus' name, yes, I declare it. Any little seed I receive, I have to share it. Brothers want to break me down and can't bear it, but heavy is the head with the crown, I still wear it. You can't hold me down. In his first interview in 3 years, which was with the journalist Louis Theroux, and it's on BBC iPlayer if anyone is interested in listening to his journey or the grime music scene. It's never too late to get interested in that. Stormzy talks openly about his growth as a person through difficult times and his journey with God and the criticism facing him as a leader on the music scene. In front of his enemies and his critics, he's put centre stage in a place in 2019 that he could only have dreamt of. He headlined the music festival Glastonbury. He was the first solo black artist to headline that festival. He played to a crowd of 250,000 people singing the words of the songs, with a further 1 million watching online. Stormzy would later come off social media to, in his words, better hear the voice of God. To dine at the table with him is to listen to his life journey, to respect his story of what it's like to be black, and to welcome without judgment someone who plays outer faults and growth centre stage. Each day, I think that we get to decide whether we're the enemy at someone else's banquet with God. In an ideal world, in a perfect kingdom, there's no enemies and we're guests together. Someone said in a meeting I was in this week, let's not let our views of what perfection looks like get in the way of progress. Progress towards perfection is what God expects and is what his grace carries us through. Progress towards perfection, and he is ready to invite us to dine with him and banquet with him along the way. How welcoming and celebratory he is when we come home to dine with him on that journey towards perfection. As we continue our Lent journey, let us remember that God is protecting us at all times. He's the great shepherd leading us. Jesus has opened the door for all of us to be children of the light. And when we humbly enter that door, God is serving a banquet to reward each of us at each stage of our life's progress. Our negative thoughts about our own worthiness and those who may judge a level of perfection in us rather than appreciate our progress will be the enemies that are looking on when we are with God, dining and celebrating. On this Mother's Day, we're invited to take time to come into unconditional love of God, our Heavenly Parent, and to ask for his help in unconditionally loving each other so that we can dine together as guests. Let's continue our worship and sing together hymn number 685, For Everyone Born a Place at the Table.
Thank you.
Let's come together in our prayer for others. Loving Father, merciful God, our refuge, our home, and the one that celebrates each of our life's journeys. Help us to be more aware of your protective presence with us, Lord, as we move through life. May we live and move in you. Take these gifts that we put before you today and let them be of work and good reach as your will sees fit within this community. Help us at each stage of our journey to seek your comfort and to receive your grace and goodness. We pray for all who seek green pastures. We pray for all who seek still waters. We pray for all who seek restoring of their soul and calm in the storms of life. We pray for those who seek the right paths before them. May your light guide them and your spirit move them. We pray for all who find themselves in dark valleys, that your love may comfort and shield the long days and nights. We pray for all those who sit with their enemies around them, that they continue to feel your protection, and may your love flow through us to everyone who crosses our path today and this week. May we be friends and not enemies to all that we meet. Help us to embrace the surprises and the challenges, whatever this day and this week may bring, accepting each as an invitation to sit with you, to dine with you, to be in your presence and learn from your grace. Set scales before us, Lord, so that on one we can pile all the discouragements of burdens and worries, wars, and disease and injustice. And on the other, we can place your word, your love, and the hope of your kingdom. Help us with your spirit, Lord. Help us to see which has true weight and a future. We thank you, Jesus, who has overcome the powers of darkness. Help us to see things in this light. Help us to share this good news with others and support others to come into your presence and the light of your kingdom. We pray that your goodness and mercy will go before us, will follow us, will uphold us and comfort us and those around us all the days of our lives. We finish our worship together this morning with hymn number 694. Brother, sister, let me serve you. bring you faultless and joyful before his glorious presence. To the only God our Saviour, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, might and authority from all ages past and now and forever and ever.